and see what Ryder and Chapman ran. This 9/11 marks two decades since the actual tragic day that so many lives were lost and so many other lives were irrevocably changed. The two decades beg us to take stock of what happened 20 years ago, of where we've been since, and of what we might do in relation to 9/11 as we go forward. The sheer shock of that act of hate has worn off. The understanding of that enmity is now a part of us. We're fatigued. We know that as hard as we may try, some will be profoundly committed against us. It's my hope that we will still try. I'm not suggesting one foreign policy initiative or another. That's beyond me. I'm suggesting, though, that we as a people face challenges, both domestic and foreign, that we do so with our eyes fixed on our moral compass and with confidence in ourselves as a nation and as a people. I emphasize the phrase, a people. It's common in 9/11 speeches to dwell on that terrific sense of unity among us that awful day in 2001 brought to us. Yet we've seen that unity fade, and we seem to confront ourselves with ever more vigor. Nonetheless, we need to know, and we do, that when needed, that oneness will rise, and we will pull together. E pluribus unum remains our way as a collection of states and as a diverse body of people. We tend to think of 20 years or so as the span of a generation. And so we have with us a generation without any personal recollection of 9/11-2001. We must recognize that with each passing year, we will lose more who were there, or who are changed by the day, and who can share this story with those who are not, in the personal way that resonates most clearly. A few days ago, I met here in Rye Paulie Veneto, the former airline cabin attendant, on the route of the Boston to LA flight that was hijacked into the side of the World Trade Center. Paulie, in remembrance of his friends who perished on that flight on that day, has just walked from Boston's Logan Airport to Ground Zero, talking to people about his friends and just what happened on 9/11-2001. Paulie has shown us that we need to tell the story, that we need to make it personal, to make it resonate, and that we must not forget each and every individual who faced the unthinkable, from the airline crews who fought the terrorists, to the passengers, to the victims on the ground, to the first responders who paid an awful price for the good they attempted to do. We owe all of them that. I want to thank all of you for coming today and taking part in our community advocate efforts. And now I'd like to introduce other electeds who will speak today. We're privileged to have Congressman Bowman with us. Unfortunately, George Latimer and Shelley Miller couldn't make it today. State Assemblyman Steve Otis is with us, as is County Legislator Catherine Parker. And with us in the audience, I see Councilman Stacks and Councilwoman Goddard.